Your number, sir? Thank you. Lot 663, then, ladies and gentlemen. A poster for this house's production of Hannibal by Chalamet. Showing here. Do I have 10 francs? 5, then. 5, I am bid. 6, 7 against you, sir. 7, 8. 8 once. Selling twice. So, to Raoul Vicomte de Chauny, thank you very much, sir. Lot 664, a wooden pistol and 3 human skulls from the 1831 production of Robert le Diable by Meyerbeer. 10 francs for this. 10, thank you. 10 still. 15, thank you. 15, I am bid. Going at 50. Your number, sir? Lot 665, ladies and gentlemen. A papier-mâché musical box in the shape of a barrel organ. Attached, the figure of a monkey in Persian robes playing the cymbals. This item discovered in the vaults of the theater. Still in working order, ladies and gentlemen. Showing here. May I commence at 20 francs? Oh, come, come, ladies and gentlemen. 15, then? 15, thank you. Yes, 20 from you, sir. Thank you very much.
25.
25 on my left. Thank you, madam. 25, I am bid. 30. Selling at 30 francs, then. 30 once. 30 twice. So! 30 francs to the Vicomte de Chauny. Thank you once again, sir. Boy.
A collector's piece, indeed. Every detail exactly as she said. She often spoke of my friend. Your velvet lining and your figurine of lead. Will you still play when all the rest of us are dead?
Lot 666, then. A chandelier, until recently believed destroyed. Some of you may recall the strange affair of the Phantom of the Opera, a mystery never fully explained. We are told, ladies and gentlemen, that this is the very chandelier which figures in the famous disaster. Our workshops have restored it and fitted parts of it with wiring for the new electric light so that we may get a hint of how magnificent it will look when reassembled. Perhaps we may frighten away the ghost of so many years ago with a little illumination. Gentlemen!
victorious drum return to bring salvation.
The trumpets of Carthage resound, hear all its cow and tremble. How to I step on the ground,
hear the drums.
No more we shall go. Signor, if you please, Rome. We say Rome, not Roma.
Si, Rome, not Roma. It's a very hard for me.
Rome. Once again,
Italiano,
please.
Signor.
Sad to return.
This way, gentlemen, this way. Rehearsals, as you see, are underway for a new production of Chalamet's Hannibal. Ladies and gentlemen, some of you may already, perhaps, have met Monsieur André and Monsieur Fermat.
I'm sorry, Monsieur Lefebvre, we are rehearsing! If you wouldn't mind waiting a moment.
My apologies, Monsieur Rayet, proceed.
Thank you, Monsieur. Sad to return, Signor.
Monsieur Rayet, our chief repetiteur, rather a tyrant, I'm afraid.
Sad to return to find the land of Villa. Retin once more by Rome's barreaching grasp. Tomorrow we shall break the chain of Rome. Tonight rejoice your army.
Pianti, our principal tenor. He does play so well opposite La Carlotta.
Gentlemen, please, if you would kindly stand to one side.
My apologies, Madame Thierry. Madame Thierry, our ballet mistress. I don't mind confessing, Monsieur Fermat. I shan't be sorry to be rid of the whole blessed business.
I keep asking you, monsieur, why exactly are you retiring?
Well, we take a particular pride here in the excellence of our ballets.
Who's that girl, Lefebvre?
Her, Meg Thierry, Madame Thierry's daughter. Promising dancer, Monsieur André, most promising. Retirement. I can now tell you that these were all true. and it is my pleasure to introduce to you the two gentlemen who now own the Opera Populaire, Monsieur Richard Thomas and Monsieur Gilles André. Ah, gentlemen, Signora Carlotta Giudicelli, our leading soprano for 5 seasons now.
Of course, of course. I have experienced all your greatest roles, Signora.
Piacere.
And Signor Ubaldo Piangi.
An honor, Signor.
Piacere.
If I remember rightly, Alyssa has a rather fine aria in Act 3 of Hannibal. I wonder, Signora, if as a personal favor, you would oblige us with a private rendition? Unless, of course, Monsieur Rayet objects.
My manager commands, Monsieur Rayet.
My diva commands. Will 2 bars be sufficient introduction?
2 bars will be quite sufficient.
Signora?
Maestro.
He is responsible for this. Get that man down here! Bouquet, for God's sakes, man, what's going on up there?
Please, monsieur, don't look at me. As God's my witness, I was not at my post. Please, monsieur, there's no one there. And if there is, well, then it must be a ghost.
He's there, the phantom of the opera.
Good heavens, I have never known such insolence!
Signora, please. These things do happen.
These things do happen? You have been here 5 minutes. What would you know? See, these things do happen. All the time. For the past 3 years, these things do happen. And did you stop them from happening? No! And you too? You're as bad as he is!
These things do happen.
Well, until you stop these things happening, this thing does not happen! Ubaldo, andiamo!
Amateurs.
I don't think there's much more I can do to assist you, gentlemen. Good luck. If you need me, I shall be in Frankfurt. Black Carlotta will be back.
You think so, monsieur? I have a message, sir, from the opera ghost.
God in heavens, you're all obsessed.
He merely welcomes you to his opera house. Commands that you continue to leave box 5 empty for his use. And reminds you that his salary is due.
His salary?
Monsieur Lefebvre paid him 20,000 francs a month. Perhaps you can afford more with the Vicomte de Charny as your patron.
Madam, I had hoped to have made that announcement myself.
Will the Vicomte be at the performance this evening, monsieur?
Yes, in our box.
Madam, who is the understudy for this role?
There is no understudy, monsieur. The production is new.
Christine Daae can singer, sir?
A chorus girl.
She's been taking lessons from a great teacher.
From whom?
I don't know, sir.
Oh, not you as well. Can you believe it, Andre? A full house and we had to cancel.
Let her sing for you, monsieur. She has been well taught.
Very well.
From the beginning of the aria, then, mademoiselle.
Where in the world have you been hiding? Really, you were.
your dancing. Then come and practice.
Rehearsals, always rehearsals.
My dear, I was asked to give you this.
A red scarf. The attic. Little Lottie.
A tour de force. No other way to describe it.
And not a single refund.
Oh, really?
Rosanna, I think we have made quite a discovery, Miss Dyer.
Well, here we are, Monsieur le Vicomte.
Gentlemen, if you wouldn't mind, this is one visit I'd prefer to make unaccompanied.
If you wish, Monsieur.
Thank you.
They appear to have met before.
Christine Dyer, where is your red scarf?
Monsieur.
You can't have lost it. Not after all the trouble I took. I was 14 and soaked to the skin.
Because you had run into the sea to fetch my scarf! Oh, no! Oh! So it is you!
Christine.
Little Lottie, let her mind wander.
You remember that too.
Little Lottie thought, am I fonder of dolls or of goblins
of shoes or of riddles of frocks?
Of picnics in the attic or of chocolates?
Father playing the violin.
Have you told each other dark stories of the North?
No, what I love best, Lottie said, is when I'm asleep in my bed and the angel of music sings songs in my head.
The angel of music sings songs in my head.
Father said, when I am in heaven, child, I will send the angel of music to you. Father is dead, Ralph, and I have been visited by the angel of music.
No doubt of that. But now we get supper.
Oh, no, Ralph, the angel of music is very strict.
No, I shan't keep you late.
No,
you must change. I must get my hat. 2 minutes, little Lottie.
Ralph! Things have changed, Ralph.
Ancient boy, the slave of fashion, asking no glory. Ignorant fool, this brave young suitor, sharing in my triumph.
Angel, I hear you speak, I listen. Stay by my side, guide me.
Thank you. You leave as you never leave. Secret. But we see, you can learn to love. You learn to see, to find the man behind the monster. This repulsive carcass, who seems a beast, but secretly means of beauty. Secret.
Return. Those two fools around my theater will be missing you. First Carlotta, now Christine. Still, at least the seats get sold. Gossip's worth its weight in gold. Diva Turner's resignation covered as a moonlight flit. Half your cast disappears, but the crowd still cheers. Opera, to hell with look and handle, have a scandal in a short abbey.
Damnable, they all walk out, this is damnable.
Hungry, please don't shout, it's publicity, and the take is vast, free publicity.
But we have no cast.
But Andre, have you seen the queue? Oh, it seems you've got one.
Dear Andre, what a charming gala. Christine enjoyed a great success. We were hardly bereft when Carlotta left. Otherwise, the chorus was entrancing, but the dancing was a lamentable mess.
Dear Fearman, just a brief reminder, my salary has not been paid. Send in care of the ghost by return of the post. PTO. No one likes a debtor, so it's better if my orders are obeyed. Who would have the gall to send this? Someone with a puerile brain. He's a ghost, signed your G.
Who the hell is he?
Opera ghost. It's really not amusing.
He's abusing our position.
In addition, he wants money. He's a funny sort of expected to expect a large retainer. Nothing's plainer. He is clearly quite fishy.
Me, Carlotta, I mean Miss Dying. Where is she?
Well, how should we know?
I want an answer. I take it that you sent me this note.
What's all this nonsense?
Of course not.
Don't look at us.
Not with you then.
Of course not. We're in the dark.
You sure don't argue. Isn't this the letter you wrote?
And what is it that we're meant to have wrote? Richard.
Do not fear for Miss Dye. The angel of music has her under his wing. Make no attempt to see her again.
If you didn't write it, who did?
Where is he?
Oh, welcome back.
Your precious paper.
Where is he? What is it now?
I have your letter. I left
couldn't have happily sent.
And did you send it?
Of course not.
As if he would.
You didn't send it?
Of course not.
What's going on?
You dare to tell me that this is not the letter you sent?
And what is it that I meant to have sent? Your days at the opera populaire are numbered. Christine Daae will be singing on your behalf tonight. Be prepared for a great misfortune should you attempt to take her place.
Far too many notes for my taste, and most of them about Christine. All we've heard since we came is Miss Daae's name.
Miss Daae has returned.
In which case, I think our meeting is adjourned.
Where precisely is she now?
I thought it best that she went home.
She needed rest.
May I see her?
No, monsieur, she will see no one.
Will she sing? Oh, will she sing?
Here, I have a note.
Let me see it.
Please. Judge, I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature, detailing how my theatre is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you one last chance.
Christine Daae has returned, and by an anxious spur of me should in the new production of Il Muto. I shall watch the performance from my normal seat in box 5, which will be kept empty for me. Should these commands be ignored, a disaster beyond your imagination
will occur. I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G. The silent room. Carl Locker will be playing the lead.
You don't deserve her.
It's no such thing to appear.
And
shouting your name. Think of how they all adore you. Prima donna, enchant us once again. Think of you and of the queues around the theatre.
Beyond all imagination.
Why? Who can this be?
Gentle wife, admit your loving husband. My love, I am called to England on affairs of state and must leave you with your new maid.
Though I'd happily take the maid with me.
The old fool is leaving.
I suspect
My young bride is untrue to me. I shall not leave, but shall hide over there to observe.
Will continue in 10 minutes' time when the role of the Countess will be sung by Miss Christine Dyer.
Ralph!
Don't worry, I'm with you. In the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, we shall be giving you the ballet from Act 3 of tonight's opera. Maestro, bring the ballet forward. The ballet. Now!
You must return.
Kill me, his eyes will find me there.
You will say that.
Those eyes that burn. If he has to kill a thousand men.
The phantom of the opera. The phantom is a fable. Believe me, there is no phantom of the opera.
My God, who is this man?
Who is this man? There is no phantom of the opera.
Now I've been there, to his word of unending light, to a world where the daylight dissolves into darkness, darkness. Now I've seen him, can I ever forget that sight? Can I ever escape from that face so distorted?
Let me lead you from your solitude. Thank you. Monsieur Firmin?
Monsieur André?
Dear André, what a splendid party. The prologue to a bright new year. By tonight I'm impressed.
Well, one does one's best.
Here's to us, the toast of all the city. Such a pity that the phantom can't be here.
Here, here.
Thank you.
Why so silent, good Monsieur? Did you think that I had left for good? Have you missed me, good Monsieur? I have returned you at last. Here I bring the finished score. Turn one triumphant. I advise you to comply. My instruction should be clear. Remember, there are worse things than a shattered chandelier. Your chains are still mine. You will sing for me.
Madame Jury! Madame Jury!
Monsieur, don't ask me. I know no more than anyone else.
That is not true. You've seen something, haven't you?
I don't know what I've seen. Please don't ask me.
Madame Jury, please, for all our sakes.
Very well. There was a travelling fair in the city. Tumblers, conjurers, human oddities.
Go on.
And there was, I shall never forget, a man locked in a cage.
In a cage?
Oh, prodigy, monsieur. Scholar, architect, musician.
A composer.
And an inventor too, monsieur. They boasted he had once built for the Shah of Persia a maze of mirrors.
Who was this man?
A freak of nature, more monster than man.
Before?
From birth, it seemed.
Go on.
And then he went missing. He escaped.
Go on.
They never found him. It was said he had died.
But he didn't die, did he?
The world forgot him, but I never can. For in this darkness
so
I have seen him
man.
Again. I have said too much, monsieur. Too much.
No, wait.
And there have been too many accidents.
Accidents? Madame Jury!
Ludicrous, have you seen the storm?
Terribly ludicrous.
It's the final storm.
This is lunacy. Well, you know my views.
Utter lunacy.
But we can't refuse.
Not another chandelier.
Look, my friend, what we have here.
Dear Andre, ring my orchestrations. We need another first bassoon. Every note's overblown, and the third trombone has to go. The man could not be deaf, so please, preferably one who plays in tune.
If him and vis-a-vis my opera, some chorus members must be sacked. If you could find out which has a sense of pitch, wisely though, I've managed to assign a rather minor role to those who cannot act.
Audrey!
What is it now?
This whole thing is an Audrey!
Signora, please.
Now, what's the matter?
Have you seen the size of my car?
Signora, listen.
It's an insult! Not you as well.
Yes, but this is an insult!
Please understand.
Signora.
The things I have to do for my art!
If you can call this gibberish art.
Ah, here is our little flower.
Ah, Miss Dye. Quite the lady of the hour.
You have secured the largest role in this Don Juan.
Christine dies, she doesn't have the voice.
Signora, please.
Then I take it you're agreeing.
She's behind us.
It appears we have no choice.
She's the one behind us, Christine dying.
How dare you?
I'm not a fool.
You evil woman, how dare you?
You think I'm blind?
Is it my fault? I don't want any part of this plot.
This guy is surely.
But why not?
What does she say?
It's your decision, but why not?
She's backing out.
You have a duty.
I cannot sing it, duty or not.
Christine, Christine, you don't have to. They can't make you.
Please, monsieur, another note.
Oh. Oh.
Fondest greetings to you.
he taught to act.
Not her normal trick of strutting round the stage.
Been blind, and yet the answer is staring us in the face. This could be the chance to ensnare our clever friend.
We're listening, go on.
We shall play his game, perform his words, and we hold the ace. For if this die sings, he is certain to attend.
We make certain the doors are barred. We make certain our men are there.
We make certain they are.
The curtain falls. His reign will end.
Madness!
I'm not so sure.
Not if it works.
This is madness!
The tide will turn.
Must you believe me? There is no way of turning the tide.
You shift your belly.
Then help us, Monsieur Ricard.
Instead of warning us,
help us.
I wish I could.
Don't make excuses.
Or could it be that you're on his side?
She's his accomplice. Monsieur, believe me, I intend no ill. But Monsieur, be careful, we have seen.
You say he'll fall us, or he will.
Every prayer rests on you now.
Piangi, here is the phrase. Those who tangle with Don Juan, if you please.
Those who tangle with Don Juan.
No, no, nearly, but no. Those who tang, tang, tang.
Those who tangle with Don Juan.
Ah, his way is better. At least he make it sound like music.
Signora, would you speak that way in the presence of the composer?
The composer is not here, and if
be certain of that, Signora?
So, once again then, if you please, Signor Piangi, after seven, five, six, seven.
Does all tangled be done well?
And you, Robson, what is the matter with Robson? He sings now as he played with the light of your arms. And does all tangled
be done well? Settle down, now, settle down!
Poor young maiden, for the thrill and the tongue of stolen sweet. You have to pay the bill.
Thank you.
wasted. Can't you see she'll never be yours? Christine! Hey! Hey, Christine!
Hello, monsieur! Such spirited words! Ah!
What tricks, monsieur?
Let's see, monsieur, how far you dare go!
Ah! More deception! More violence!
That's right! Keep walking this way!
You can't win her love by making her your prisoner!
Ah!
Stay back!
I'm here! I'm here, monsieur, the angel of death! Come on! Come on! Don't stop! Don't stop! Ah! Don't go! So be it! Well, let it be war upon you both!
You understand their instructions?
Sir,
can you hear the whistle? Take up your positions. I shall instruct you to secure the doors. It is essential. And all doors are properly secure.
Andre, are you sure we're doing the right thing?
Have you got a better idea?
Monsieur le Vicomte! Might you give the order?
Give the order.
You, in the pit there. Do you have a clear view of this box?
Yes, sir.
Remember, when the time comes, shoot. But only if you have to. But shoot to kill.
How will I know, sir?
You'll know.
Monsieur le Vicomte, are you confident this will work? Will Miss die, eh, sir?
Don't worry, Fleming. Andre, we're in your hands, monsieur.
My men are now in position, sir.
Go ahead, then.
Are the doors secure?
Secure. Secure.
Secure.
Hold your fire!
I'm here, the Phantom of the Opera! I'm here! I'm here!
You fool! I said only when the time comes!
But Monsieur le Vicomte!
For once, Monsieur le Vicomte is right. See my fate tonight, I hate to have to cut the gun short, but thy don't spare me in. Let the ordeal take, let my opera
with me, where, oh, where, of course, my room. For
something hasn't got a chance.
Here's my hat, my cloak, and sword. Conquest is assured. If I do not forget myself enough.
Speech disappears into silence.
sir.
Haunted face holds no horror for me.
wait. I think, my dear, we have a guest. Sir, this is indeed an unparalleled delight. I had hardly dreamt we'd be so blessed. Yet now my wish comes true. You have truly made my night.
Free her, do what you like, only free her. Have you no pity?
Your lover makes a passionate plea.
He's well, it's useless.
I love her, does that mean nothing? I love her, show some compassion.
The world shall no compassion to me.
Christine, Christine, let me see her.
Be my guest. Monsieur, I bid you welcome. Did you think that I would harm her? Why would I make her pay for the sins which are yours? Are they off my horses now? Raise up your hand to the level of your eyes. Nothing can save you now, except perhaps Christine. Make your choice.
Give me courage to show you. You are
forget me, forget all of this.
This is one star, this star.
Leave me alone! Forget all you see. Go now, go let them find you. Take the boat, swear to me, never to tell. The secrets you know, the names we know.
Thank you.